everybody. Today I want to show you our visit to the Morris Arboretum and Gardens. This is a spectacular place with so many things to see. There are beautiful gardens, especially the Rose Garden. There are sculptures, there are fountains. It's just a beautiful place to walk through. A bit of history. This was the estate of John and Lydia Morris. They were siblings. They purchased the land back in 1887 and built a mansion and other buildings on the property and even a greenhouse. It was their intention to create a beautiful public garden and an educational center. They named the mansion Compton. The Morrises traveled extensively in Europe and brought back lots of ideas for their gardens and specimens for the gardens. The family's money came from a company that built steam engines, boilers, and machinery. John died in 1915, but Lydia carried on maintaining the estate. Lydia Morris died in 1932. After her death, she left the estate to the University of Pennsylvania. The garden became open to the public in 1933. She stipulated that the Compton Mansion be demolished after her death. The University of Pennsylvania moved two academic departments, botany and landscaping, into the Compton Mansion. Lydia did not get her request that the mansion be demolished until 1968. So now we have a beautiful garden and we have an educational center, just what the Morrises had planned. In this video, you will see a lot of sites that the Morris Arboretum is famous for. The Canopy Walk, the Rose Garden, the Swan Pond, the Garden Railway, and more. There was so much to see. You really should go. It's a beautiful place to visit. One little bit of disappointment was in the Rose Garden, we couldn't walk in the grass. They're renovating the grass, and we had to stay on the paved areas. Enjoy the video. The Widener Center was once the carriage house for the Compton Estate. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe if you want to see more garden videos. I'll see you next time.